Okay, we want to find the unit tangent and unit normal vector to this vector function at the point t equals 0. Now for that, we're going to need to start by finding the regular old tangent vector. So taking the derivative of this, we got root 2 e to the t, and using chain rule, negative e to the negative t. Now in order to find the unit tangent vector, we're going to need to take the tangent vector and divide it by the magnitude of the tangent vector to make a unit vector. So we're going to need the magnitude of this tangent vector. So let's go ahead and see if we can figure that out. So square root of root 2 squared plus e to the t squared plus negative e to the negative t squared. Now let's see if we can simplify that a bit. So root 2 squared is 2, e to the t squared is e to the 2t. Here the negative will square away, we'll be left with an e to the negative 2t. Now oftentimes with this type of problem we hope that this square root will simplify. It won't always, but in this case hopefully it will. So we ask, is there some way I can factor this, ideally, as a perfect square here? So let's hear it. This was e to the t squared, so maybe we can think of that as e to the t. And this was e to the negative t squared, so maybe we can think e to the negative t there. And notice if we were to multiply this out, we'd get e to the t times e to the t. The outer and inner terms would both be e to the t times e to the negative t, which would just be 1. We got an inner and outer adding up to 2, and then the last gives us the negative 2t squared. Great, so there we go. And so our magnitude of the tangent vector is just going to be e to the t plus e to the negative t. So my unit tangent vector then will be the original tangent vector divided by this magnitude, so which means we're going to divide each component. So we'll have root 2 over e to the t plus e to the negative t. We'll have e to the t over e to the t plus e to the negative t. And we'll have negative e to the negative t over e to the t plus e to the negative t. There we are. And there is our unit tangent vector. And if we were to evaluate that at 0, we would get root 2 over e to the 0 is 1, as is e to the negative t. So e to the 0 plus e to the 0, 1 plus 1 is 2. Here we got 1 over 2, and here we have negative 1 over 2. Okay, and there is our unit tangent vector at 0. Now, to find the unit normal vector, we're going to need to take the derivative of, right, because the unit normal vector is going to be the derivative of the unit tangent vector divided by the magnitude of the unit tangent vector. And so, now we're going to need to take the derivative of that unit tangent vector. So continuing on, we're going to find the derivative of the unit tangent vector. So now we get to find the derivative of this, which, as you can see, is going to be a little, well, maybe more than a little bit messy, because we're going to need to use quotient rule here. So we're going to get bottom times the derivative of the top minus top times derivative of the bottom. So e to the t minus e to the negative t is the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. For the next term, we're going to get low. So bottom times derivative of the top minus top times derivative of the bottom, all over the bottom squared. And I'm running out of room, so I'm going to jog down here. And so for the last one, we got So bottom times the derivative of the top. So the negative went away on the derivative there, minus top times derivative of the bottom, all over the bottom squared. And as you can see, that's pretty crazy, and trying to find the magnitude of that sounds really daunting. Luckily, because we were looking for, remember, we were looking for the unit normal vector at a point, we can go ahead and evaluate this at a point, at zero, before finding the magnitude. Now, we couldn't do that earlier because we were going to need to take the derivative of the unit tangent vector. But we're not going to be taking the derivative of n, and so we can go ahead and do that here. So going ahead and plugging in 0 for t, let's see what we get. So the first thing we might notice is that e to the 0 plus e to the 0 is going to be 2, and so both of these, all of these denominators are going to be 4. Second thing we might notice is that e to the t minus e to the negative t at 0, e to the 0 minus e to the 0 will be 0. So these terms are all going to end up being 0. So here this is multiplying 0 as well, and so that first term is just going to end up being 0. Here we've got 1 plus 1 is 2 times 1 is 2 minus 0, so we're going to get 2 fourths, and here we're going to get 1 plus 1 is 2 times e to the 0 is 1, so again 2 fourths. And so we're going to end up with the vector 0, 1 half, 1 half as the derivative of big T at 0. Now we're going to need to find the magnitude of that. So coming up here now, the magnitude of big T prime at 0 will be square root of 0 squared plus 1 half squared plus 1 half squared. So we got 1 quarter plus 1 quarter is 1 half. So we got square root of 1 half as our magnitude of big T prime. And so our unit normal vector at 0 will be our big T prime, 0, 1 half, 1 half, all divided by root 1 half. And that gives us the vector 0, root 1 half, root 1 half, as our unit normal vector at 0. So combining that with our previous results, there's big T at 0. There is big N, the unit normal vector, at 0.